The day that it happened was December 19th of 2018. Perfectly normal day for me. I work as a diesel mechanic. I work at a shop that does a lot of roadside service. I got to my job site that evening, which was mile marker 136 on Interstate 44. Changing tires on the side of the interstate is never safe, but this particular night, I had one that I thought was a pretty safe bet. You know, it was a nice straight shot on that section of interstate. I had good visibility both directions. You know, I had all of my flashing lights on my truck. I had my cones out. I was set up to be as safe as I could. And I turned around and I bent over. Just like that, I was laying in the middle of the right lane of the interstate. And it took me a second to realize what had happened. I, you know, looked around, realized where I was, kind of scooted over under the semi-trailer that I had been working on. And so I scooted up underneath the trailer. I had to dig around in my pocket and find my phone, called 911. You know, when the paramedics got there and they saw how bad I was, they immediately called for the helicopter to come and pick me up. So they shut down traffic both ways, landed the helicopter on the interstate, loaded me up. And, you know, I tell people a lot of times, you know, the most painful part of that night was not getting hit by a car. It was actually getting rolled onto my back, onto that backboard. The pain was, it was horrific. I have an older brother who's a police officer in Springfield, Missouri. He was waiting on the helipad. He knew more about what was wrong with me than I did. And so he was there expecting to receive my body. Then they, you know, rolled me into the hospital. I have a vague memory of fluorescent lights over my head. And that's the last thing I remember from December 19th of 2018 until January 3rd of 2019. The doctors at Mercy Hospital in Springfield, Missouri, obviously did their best. You know, they didn't just give up on me, but it was unlikely that I would make it. My wife was told when she arrived at the hospital that first night, the doctors told her to make sure that she said goodbye to me that night because I wasn't going to be alive in the morning. And she was reminded of that every day for at least a couple of weeks that I likely wouldn't be there in the morning. With the level of trauma and wounds that I had, with the amount of just missing flesh and the amount of blood that I lost, there was no expectation that I would survive. She went through a lot, you know, having to come to grips with the fact that your husband is dying. And for my kids to understand that, you know, Daddy might not make it. That was, I'm glad I wasn't awake for that. I don't think I could handle it. They had to place me in a medically induced coma. The left side of my pelvis was completely shattered. The biggest piece of bone left in there was about the size of a piece of gravel. Within the first 3 months in the hospital, I had probably 20-some surgeries, and I've had many surgeries since then. I was in the hospital from December 19th of 2018 all the way until the end of August 2019. I was there 8 months in the hospital before I went home for the first time.
Do your right foot.
It was pretty amazing to be able to take those steps again. So the thing that kind of bothers me about the way this happened is it didn't have to happen. It's infuriating to think that I could have died, that somebody could have been killed, and people are killed almost daily by these kinds of things that are easily preventable just by paying attention, following the rules of the road. You're putting the lives of yourself and others in your hands every time you get behind the wheel. And you think, oh, I'm just gonna look down for a second at this text. But 1 second can end somebody's life.